Also, I have been really overwhelmed, and I understand this, with emails from people asking me to detail the battery life problem that I've been experiencing with all of my iOS devices the past month. Because battery life is it's a universal complaint that people have. And folks, the problem I had is not something that it was not related to settings like notifications or location services or background app refresh. It was much, much, much more severe. It was not, you couldn't fix it. You could make a change difference in it whatsoever by toying around with settings. It was far, far deeper problem than that, which is why it required installing a couple of profiles to create logs of behavior taking place on the five of the devices. And then the reams of data that was produced had to be examined in order to find the culprit. And I'm going to explain it at some point in the program today, because people, I said yesterday, nobody cares, and a lot of people actually do. Battery life, a universal complaint that people have. But again, what I'm going to tell you my solution was, I'm not advocating anybody do. My problem was drastic and totally outside the norm and could not be dealt with by standard, ordinary changes in settings or other behaviors. In fact, well, I'll tell you what I'm going to do. I am going to very soon, hopefully, have a section on my website for tech tips. Because I know you people in the stick to the issues crowd get very upset when I start talking about my passions that are not related to politics, whatever they may be, the NFL, golf, my iOS devices. I can hear you. I can see you out there shouting at the radio and throwing things at it. Stick to the issues. I know you're out there. But this was a dramatic, I'd never seen anything like it, problem. And nobody else was experiencing it. And nobody had, I mean, every suggestion was a suggestion that I could come up with myself. There was not one person who had one idea what was wrong. And had I not been able to get really deep help, I would have never figured this out. I would have had to just adjust to the fact that my iPhone 6S would die every 4 hours, which meant that it would just have to be constantly charging, make it unusable. So I'll detail that too as the program unfolds before your very eyes.